Si l'on en croit Claude Lévi-Strauss,
if we believe Claude Lévi-Strauss, everything lies in the origins, at the origin of the sustainable development concept. An observation was made. There have been ecologic and social crises, and they are brought together and intertwined. He said, there is not an isolated crisis, an environmental crisis on one side, a development crisis, or an energy crisis separated. No, there is only one crisis. Therefore, this is a political reflection, because the question is raised on the political level. How do we reconcile the stakes of human development and the environmental limits? The question, therefore, is how do we build a world order which is compatible with finiteness? Obviously, this proposal is very political in essence. It analyzes the consequences of adding all those crises. And one element is underlined, the fact that our development model might break with the formula which is usually used. In French, we say, on va dans le mur, we're heading for the wall. Jacques Chirac, the French President of the Republic, in Johannesburg in 2002, said that this was urgent. It was our responsibility to face the emergency. And he said that this was a civilization crisis. 25 years later, what is the situation? How has the concept been used? Sustainable development is first and foremost a method suggestion. How to find a method which is compatible with social and environmental constraints. This is the idea that we've developed together with the idea of environmental development. The pattern is quite conventional. It became very popular, and you can find it in all the documents on sustainable development. The fact that those three discs are superimposed, environment, economy, and social. And the fact that they are superimposed and are intertwined suggests several elements. First, we need to change the decision-making process. We must enlarge the scope of the decisions taken. We must bring in more players, more stakeholders, more women, more poor people, and companies, for instance. And also, we need to work on the way the decision is taken, i.e., people must participate in the decision. Individuals must participate. And finally, it is necessary that we change the functioning and the orientation of public administration. We work on cross-border administrative work and environmental questions, which become employment questions, etc. Another dimension, time. Here, we need to work on the continuity between present and future generations. And finally, we need to work on the territorial dimension, the relationship between local and global, and the other way around, from global to local. The method has an objective. How do we change individual behaviors and collective behaviors? And how do we change the productive model so that it becomes more compatible with the environmental limits? Now, how does it translate in public policies? Well, there are three ways mainly. First of all, codification. The sustainable development concept will become legal principles, administrative standards locally, but also internationally. Second level, institutionalization of the system. The state, the local administrations, the public services, local and international, must try and elaborate public policies which can be called sustainable. The third level, possibly the one that has developed most, is that of professionalization of sustainable development. Very quickly, people have developed a certain kind of expertise on sustainable development. There are experts, and these experts come up with methods and sets of references and indicators. In the university, new courses, training courses have emerged called sustainable development, and many students are being trained and educated. The whole point is to create the conditions for a sort of turnkey sustainable development, something that can be applied easily overnight. One may consider that this has led to more technical than political orientations. Obviously, progress, technical progress has been made in housing, energy, transportation. Everything is greener. There are environmental friendly living areas or festivals or consumption modes. But we also have a multiplicity of experiments. Towns and local administrations have organized groups, associations, each trying to invent a way to implement sustainable development. Now, the multiplicity of experiments conducted leads us to a rather confused situation where we cannot find which are the real priorities. For instance, a social matter is very often sacrificed for the benefit of strictly environmental policies or economic objectives connected with sustainable development. What it boils down to is that we don't always grasp exactly what is the political project expected behind the multiplicity of experiments. Codification, institutionalization, this is work aiming at standardizing sustainable development in a way. As you can derive from this graph, it's all about realigning the initial objectives of sustainable development, and finally, sustainable development becomes a consensual form of thought, much better adjusted to economic development priorities, the so-called green growth, which comes with the sustainable development objective, the liberal paradigm, the managerial paradigm, individual priorities are all preserved, the consequences being that we push away the idea of finiteness, which was really at the origin of sustainable development. Therefore, sustainable development is standardized in its terminology, in its set of references and tools, and it loses its political value. It no longer refers to the collective project and the capacity to implement the project for the benefit of shorter term achievements. In conclusion, let us come back to the Brundtland report. According to the Brundtland report in 87, when the report was published, it says we have 5,000 days between today and the year 2000 in order to do important things. Now, obviously, ever since the report was published, we have seen far too many sustainable policies. The notion has made a lot of buzz, but this has led to a rather blurry situation. There have been policies regarding education for sustainable development, and there have been international meetings which supposedly were going to generate political orientations, etc. That if we take stock of the situation, there is a lot to criticize because social tensions and environmental tensions have become worse, and the crisis has never been so severe. For instance, think about social inequalities and ecological inequalities, not just one or the other, but both of them together. Therefore, we have even less time to think of new solutions. Yes, one might consider that the sustainable development is an underused concept, but on the other hand, we may also think that right from the beginning, there were many things that sustainable development had underestimated. The asymmetric strength of powers between the economic and the environmental power was underestimated, and also some things have been left aside, like the problem of nuclear energy. So we have to work with our fantasy to solve the problem and find something that is akin to strong durability. Günther Anders, the philosopher, said, please use your imagination, try to extend it so that it remains at par with what you have done and the consequences of your actions.